Who's there?
Left no evidence behind. Yeah, they were good. But unfortunately for them, so am I. Vince, I know you're the best detective in the whole world, but are you sure you'll be able to solve this one? Trust me, there's no case I can't solve. They don't call me the best detective in the world for no reason. Plus, I've already spotted one crucial piece of evidence right here. What is it? The killer did leave one thing behind, and it's right in front of us. The body. Oh, I never even thought of that. Nah, don't worry. That's why they call me in for stuff like this. I'll start looking around to see if anyone knows who this person could be, gather a list of suspects, so we can figure out who on earth could have done this. I believe in you, Detective. Heh. Yeah. So do I.
Who in their right mind would want to kill such a fine-looking man? But first, let's find out who you are. Ding dong, ding, ding.
É só isso, meu baião, e não tem mais nada, não. O meu coração pediu assim, só.
I'm starting to wonder if I'll ever solve this case.
Do not give up. Remain patient, and the clues will come to you. That's what I've taught you ever since you were a young detective.
I know, and that's what's helped me make sure I never leave a case unsolved. But I'm starting to think this one might be unsolvable.
Perhaps it is. Or perhaps it is the universe telling you that some things should remain unsolved.
But if I can't solve this one, then it'll be the end of my career.
Well, maybe it is time to consider retirement soon. You've already been on the force so long now, you're older than I was when I first mentored you.
Yeah, and I'm still nowhere near as good of a detective as you were.
Do not compare your achievements to those of others. Being the best detective in the world is still a title to be proud of.
No. I have to be the best detective of all time, no matter the cost.
I can see you still have the same undying motivation for solving mysteries as when you were young.
Yes, because it's been my life's purpose ever since I found my father's killer and avenged his death. I knew at that moment this was the life I was destined for.
And destined for it you were. Now, I only hope nothing stands in the way of you achieving your destiny.
Oh, I'll make sure nothing stands in my way.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know this person?
Why, yes. That's my husband.
Yes!
May I ask what this is regarding?
Oh, yeah. You might want to sit down for a minute.
He's been killed. Who would do such a thing?
That's what I'm trying to figure out. Would you happen to know if your husband had anyone who would want him dead?
No, as far as I know, he didn't have a single enemy in the world. I wouldn't see why anyone would want to kill him. He was always such a kind person.
Do you know where he was headed the evening he was killed?
To volunteer at the soup kitchen for blind orphans.
No wonder there were no eyewitnesses.
Please, Detective, whatever you do, please find whoever killed my husband. Do it for me.
Well, it sure is a tough case. But as the best detective in the world, I promise you, I'll solve it.
Oh, thank you, Detective.
All right. See you later.
Looks like you're not so blind, are you?
Who are you?
I'm investigating a murder that happened here, and I think I just found myself a suspect.
What? What are you talking about?
Don't you think it's a little bit suspicious that nobody witnessed the murder because they're all blind? And now it turns out you're a faker?
But I am blind.
Heh. Yeah. Sure you are.
Ow, why'd you do that?
Wait, you are blind?
Yeah, I told you.
Oh, kid, I'm sorry.
What scent of cologne are you wearing?
I think it's cigarette butts and gasoline. Why?
I've gotta get going. Please, just don't hurt me.
Alright, just don't tell the police force about what I did to you.
I won't. I won't, I promise.
Okay. Go along then.
Move here, kid.
Have you found any new clues?
Not much. I'm beginning to think there's more to this case than meets the eye. I was talking with one of the blind orphans. He was acting pretty suspiciously.
Do you think he did it?
No, he was blind. But I think he may know something that I don't.
How so?
I need to know. Do you, by any chance, think your husband may have been keeping any secrets from you?
Well, now that you mention it, I'm not entirely sure if he was always going to the soup kitchen for the reason he was saying.
What makes you think that?
I know he was a good man, but I just found it so hard to believe that someone would be willing to volunteer so much just out of the goodness of their heart.
What do you think he was doing?
I don't know. It's just a hunch.
Well, it's better than nothing.
It's just that he's dead now. I don't want to start questioning him after the fact. You understand, don't you?
Yeah, I do. If you want to leave it at that, that's fine.
You know, I can't believe I was skeptical of my husband's good intentions. But I think you truly do have good intentions.
Well, of course I do.
Thank you, Detective. I don't think I can thank you enough.
That's all right. It's all in a day's work.
Hello?
It's me.
Oh, Detective. How's the case going?
Not so well. Seems like there's lots below the surface here, but I'm still mostly getting dead ends.
Is there anything I can help with?
Believe it or not, I think so. Can you head down to the soup kitchen for blind orphans? Start looking around for some more info and whatnot?
Yeah, I'll get right on it.
Oh, and by the way, make sure you don't wear any strong scented cologne.
Okay. Hey there, kid. I'm with the police. You think you could answer me some questions?
Didn't one of your detectives just come by earlier to question me?
Yeah, I just have a few more questions I'd like to ask.
Well, good, because I have a few more things to tell you.
Oh, all right. Go ahead.
So, now, I'll just have to see what he's able to get.
Something is very wrong with you, Vincent.
Huh? What are you talking about?
Look at yourself. This case is taking its toll on you.
Yeah, well, it's what it is.
Why are you doing this to yourself?
I told you a million times before, I never left a case unsolved. And I'm not gonna leave this one unsolved either.
But I've never seen you do this to yourself before.
Well, I also promised this lady I'd find whoever killed her husband for her, so...
I see. And now the added pressure from this woman is eating away at you from within, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, a bit. I just want to find this person and get this over with.
Well then, perhaps you should take a rest. Search within yourself first.
Huh? No.
I'm not tired.
Where am I? What's going on?
You are searching the inner depths of your mind.
But why?
You say you want to find the killer, but you have to look no further than at yourself.
What are you saying?
I think you know exactly what I'm saying. You just need to accept it. You got too good at solving crimes. Nothing's enough for you anymore. So eventually, you resorted to setting up a case for yourself. You made the most difficult case you would ever face. A case so difficult that not even you could solve it. And then, you asked me to erase your memory so you wouldn't remember. I only agreed because I didn't want to see my student turn to crime any longer.
No.
I'm sorry that I have failed you. I don't have the strength to turn you into the authorities, but I can no longer teach you now that you've broken the detective code.
Wait, Vincent!
Goodbye, Vincent.
No! No!
Is everything all right, Detective?
Yeah, I think I've made some real good progress on this case.
That's good to hear. What can you tell me? Detective? What's wrong?
I don't know what to say.
Oh, please. Please tell me.
I've never left a case unsolved before. But now, I wish I left this one unsolved.
What are you trying to tell me?
Detective Vincent Solomon, you are under arrest.
Take one more step and I slice her throat.
Why would you do this, Vince? You were the best detective in the world. And now you just went and threw it all away.
I don't know.
What are you talking about?
Ma'am, this is the man right here responsible for killing your husband.
Detective? But why?
I said, I don't know. I don't even remember doing it, so I'm sorry.
Well, that's too bad, Vince. But I'm still gonna have to bring you in. So just put the knife down, and we can make this easy.
Why should I? I've nothing left anymore. Once the best detective in the world, and now I'm a wanted criminal.
Oh, come on. I know you. You wouldn't do this.
I thought I knew myself, too. And look at what I ended up doing anyways.
Don't do it, Vince.
If you love me, let me know.
What do you mean we can't air it?
I mean, we can't air this and risk getting poor ratings.
What does it matter? It's the series finale anyways.
Well, we still want audiences to have a positive memory with our brand. Having the good guy suddenly do non-good guy things isn't a good look for us.
Fine! If people don't like it, just put the blame on me. I don't care. It's my show anyways.
Yeah, it may be your show, but we run it. And even though this is the finale, we're still gonna have to make profits from merchandise. So we gotta keep the good guy detective look.
You kidding me? I played your stupid game for 8 years, always making whatever dumb changes you wanted to keep your profits up. And now you cancel my show, and can't even let me have this?
What can I tell you?
Detective? What's wrong?
I don't know what to say. But you did it, didn't you?
Aha!
Rats! How'd you figure it out?
Easy. I'm just the best detective in the world. Now take her away.
Another job well done, detective. Now come on, you evil husband murderer.
Hello? Mr. Mayor? You want to speak with me? All right.
Congratulations, detective. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. It's an honor.
It's my pleasure. After you've had such a long and prestigious career as a detective, it's obvious that you deserve it.
Speaking of which, I was thinking maybe it's about time I hang things up. Well, I'd be lying if I said I wouldn't miss you. But it's about time you have a break. Go on. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.